In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I invite you to stand for the penitential rite. We gather here this morning to celebrate Requiem Mass for Maureen Keegan, to give thanks to God for her life on this earth, to give thanks to God for the gifts he gave her, gifts that we received through Maureen. And we pray at this Requiem Mass for Maureen's eternal repose. We pray also for the consolation of those who mourn her passing from this world. And to prepare ourselves then to celebrate Requiem Mass, we pause for a moment to call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Maureen, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. I invite you now to be seated while the scripture readings this morning will be read for us by Aaron and Josh.
First reading, a reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Lord will destroy death forever. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all people a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all people and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God, in whom we hope for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us." The word of the Lord. Response: The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With those you give me comfort.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. I am already on the point of being sacrificed. The time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me on the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on the day, and not only to me, but to all who have loved his appearing. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
It is my Father's will, says the Lord, that whoever believes in the Son shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We gather here today in St. John the Baptist Church in these straitened circumstances wrought by the coronavirus pandemic to bid our farewell to Maureen Keegan, to pray for the happy repose of her soul, and to pray also for the consolation of those who mourn her passing from this world, especially her son and daughter, Michael and Siobhan, and her surviving brother, Terry. My own experience of death is that the death of a loved one is always difficult. No matter how many birthdays have been reached, no matter how frail or confused a loved one has become, we always experience pain, real sorrow, and immense loss when one whom we have loved dearly passes from our world. So, at a sad time like this for her loved ones, what can Maureen's family hold on to that will help ease that pain, that sense of loss? Well, firstly, we can recall that Maureen enjoyed 77 years of life on this earth, and received many graces and blessings from God down through those years. One of four siblings born to Kate and Tommy Shevlin, Maureen came into this world on the 30th of June 1943. Having checked the baptismal register, I saw that Maureen was baptized by the then curate in the parish, Father Kelly, just 2 days after her birth, baptized on the 2nd of July 1943, her godmother on the day being Mary O'Neill. Following her education with the Presentation Sisters, Maureen was gainfully employed in the local schools as a dinner lady and also in Pieman Cafe. She married her late husband Jackie on the 21st of February 1968 in our parish, the best man on the day being Peter Keegan and the bridesmaid being Nolene McNally, with Father Quinn officiating on their big day. Maureen and Jackie brought two of a family into this world, Michael and Siobhan, who in turn gave Maureen four grandchildren. Poor Maureen was dealt the really cruel blow of losing her husband Jackie at a young age when he died in the summer of 1977, a mere 9 years into their marriage. Next, we can remember Maureen's faithfulness. A great virtue in the Old Testament is the virtue of faithfulness, that is, sticking to one's convictions and commitments through thick and thin. And this can be said of Maureen Keegan. She was a faithful daughter of the parish of Drumcree and a good and attentive mother to Michael and Siobhan, as she battled on rearing them following the death of Jackie while she was still a young woman. Thirdly, Maureen's loved ones can be consoled by their memories of her. Memory, the human memory, is a really wonderful thing, for at will we can recall incidents and events that make us realise just how special and unique a person Maureen Keegan was. Siobhan and Michael, you will likely remember your mum when she was hale and healthy, rearing you single-handedly through those tough and oft-times sad years of the Troubles. Maureen's brother Terry, I'm sure, will be able to remember growing up with Maureen in the lean, hungry years of the Second World War and in the years following the Second World War. Maureen's older grandchildren will likely remember their granny when she was fit and well before the onset of dementia, when she would have delighted in spoiling her grandchildren. Grannies are fantastic at that. Spoiling, they're far better at that than with their own children, in my experience. Spoiling the grandchildren, the grandchildren are led away with blue murder compared to what we might have been led away with. Siobhan was telling me in Quinn's funeral home over the week how her mum loved nothing more than having her hair done twice a week. She'd have a job during this pandemic. And of Maureen's simple pleasures of a weekend away or a night out with family and friends, all of which I was reliably informed in Charlie Mallon's the other day, paled into insignificance compared to her thrill at playing bingo, at which I'm told she was remarkably lucky. Cherish those memories of Maureen, because the way you remember your mum, your sister, your granny, your neighbour, your sister-in-law, is the way she is in the eternal present of God's presence. That's how Maureen is, how you remember her. And fourthly, in the Apostles' Creed, which we learned as children and which is recited on Sundays at Mass, we pray these words: I believe in the communion of saints. It is part of our Catholic faith that in God's time, Maureen will join this communion of saints who enjoy the constant vision of God's glory, and that Maureen will be able to intercede for the rest of us left behind, still on our own journey of faith. Maureen may well never make it into the list of canonized saints, but a saint she will be, finding her true home in heaven, for as our gospel passage from St. John this morning expresses it, there are many rooms in my Father's house. Fifthly and finally, I think there is much consolation to be had from the beauty of today's funeral liturgy or Requiem Mass. In times past, certainly I know when I was a child, death was something to be greatly feared because of our perception of a judgmental God. However, our funeral liturgy this morning presents us with the love, mercy, and compassion of a kind and caring God. that first reading from the prophet Isaiah provides us with a very wholesome, consoling image of the afterlife, when the Lord will prepare a banquet of rich food. And I believe Maureen enjoyed her grub in Rosemount. And the Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. And Maureen's loved ones will derive immense consolation from that second reading from St. Paul to Timothy, where he says, "The time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race." While the gospel passage from St. John tells us, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. There are many rooms in my Father's house. I am going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me." So this morning, as we bid farewell to a much loved mother, granny, sister, mother-in-law, sister-in-law, friend, neighbour and daughter of Drumcree Parish, despite that sense of loss and sorrow, we face the future with courage and hope, knowing that is what Maureen would want and expect us to do. We comfort and console one another in the sure confidence that for Maureen Keegan, life has changed, not ended, as the preface of our Mass so eloquently expresses it. And we derive comfort and solace from the fact that Maureen has indeed fought the good fight. She has finished the race. To Siobhan and Michael, to Maureen's four grandchildren, to Terry, Justin, Dorothy and Annette, I extend my sympathy and condolences and those of my colleague, Father Clark, on the loss of your mum, your granny, your sister, your mother-in-law, your sister-in-law, your friend, and your old neighbour. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. May she rest in peace. I invite you now to stand for the prayers of the faithful, which will be led for us today by Jenna, Megan, and Barry. God the Father brought his Son through the darkness of Calvary to the glory of the resurrection. We are confident that he will bring us also through the darkness of death to his kingdom of light and peace. Let us now turn to him with our prayers, petitions, and intercessions.
That Christ, to whom Maureen was united in baptism, may welcome her into heaven and give her a share in his glory. Lord, hear us. For all Maureen's extended family and friends, that they may find comfort in their faith in God and strength through the love and support of family and friends. Lord, hear us.
For those who looked after and cared for Maureen, that their generosity may be rewarded with abundant blessings. Lord, hear us.
For all the faithfully departed, especially those who were dear and very special to us, we remember in a special way Maureen and her late husband Jackie, her mother and father Kate and Tommy. We remember all the deceased members of the Keegan and Shevlin families, and we pray that they and all our deceased loved ones, freed from the shadow of death, may take their place in the new creation where all tears are wiped away. Lord, hear us. For all those who are suffering the consequences of the current coronavirus pandemic, that God the Father may grant health to the sick, strength to those who care for them, comfort to the families, and salvation to all the victims who have died. Lord, hear us.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, give us the certainty that beyond death there is a life where broken things are mended and lost things are found, where there is rest for the weary and joy for the sad, where all that we have loved and willed of good exists, and where we will meet again those who are dear to us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you now to be seated for the Eucharist. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Maureen, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful people, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Eamon, our Bishop, Michael, his assistant bishop, Sean, our retired bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember your servant Maureen Keegan, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. Amen. I invite you now all to stand so that we can pray together in the words our Saviour gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For the distribution of Holy Communion, if you can come up by the main aisle and go back to your seats by the side aisle so as to observe social distancing.
I watch the sunrise, lighting the sky, casting its shadows near. And on this morning, bright though it be, I feel old shadows near me. But you are always close to me, following all my ways. May I be always close to you, following all your ways, Lord. I watch the sunlight shine through the clouds, warming the earth below. And at the midday, life seems to say, I feel your brightness near me. For you are always close to me, following all my ways. May I be always close to you, following all your ways, Lord. I watch the sunset fading away, lighting the clouds with sleep. And as the evening closes its eyes, I feel your presence near me.
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacred heart of Jesus, Immaculate Heart of Mary, and for protection today and every day. O angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love commits thee here, ever this day be at my side, to light, to guard, to rule and guide. Amen. Let us stand and pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Maureen may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Maureen. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet Maureen again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. We pray in silence for Maureen's eternal repose, during which time I will sprinkle her mortal remains with holy water to remind us of that day on the 2nd of July 1943, when she was baptized not only into the death of Christ, but baptized also into the resurrection of Christ. And when I have done that, I will then incense Maureen's mortal remains with the thurible. And the reason we do that in the Catholic tradition is because Maureen's body was once the temple of the Holy Spirit. And as the smoke billows out of the thurible from the incense and rises upwards, that will reflect and mirror all our prayers for Maureen, for Michael and Siobhan, and for Terry, rising up into the presence of God. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to her aid, hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Maureen Keegan in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Maureen in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with our sister forever and ever. Amen. In peace, let us now take Maureen to her place of rest.
Hail Queen of Heaven, the ocean star, guide of the wanderer here below, throne mother of Christ, star of the sea, pray for the wanderer, pray for me. O gentle, chaste, and spotless maid, we sinners make our prayers through thee. Remind thy Son that he has paid the price of our iniquity. Virgin most pure, star of the sea, pray for the sinner.